Keir Starmer promised sunlight of hope after Labour roared to election victory in early July, ending 14 years of Conservative rule. But the new government's first 100 days in power have been rather gloomy. From gaping fiscal black holes and impending tax rises to the winter fuel fiasco, here's what's been going on. Labour's economic strategy has become clear. Short-term pain for long-term gain. Britain's foundations must be ripped out and rebuilt. And some of the early building blocks have been well received. The government launched a landmark pensions review, unveiled reforms for a long-term housing strategy, and scrapped plans to introduce a controversial British ISA. There was also long-awaited cheer for borrowers after interest rates were cut for the first time in 4 years. But pretty much everything else has been bleak. The big development came in late July with the discovery of a $22 billion fiscal black hole, allegedly left by the Tories, a claim they staunchly refute. To balance the Treasury's books, Chancellor Rachel Reeves says the government needs to cut spending and notably raise taxes. We'll learn more of the new government's first budget on the 30th of October. And according to Starmer, it's going to be painful, which has sent the tax hiking rumour mill into overdrive. The government has already proposed to introduce VAT on private school fees, but Labour's manifesto pledge not to raise the headline rates of income tax, national insurance, VAT and business taxes means its options are limited. The Prime Minister says those with the broadest shoulders should bear the heaviest burden, with reforms to capital gains tax, inheritance tax and pension taxation reportedly on the government's radar. But increases to these taxes would be deeply unpopular. Spook savers are already raiding their pensions in fear the tax-free cash element will be reduced or scrapped. However, Labour's move in mid-August to axe winter fuel payments for 10 million pensioners proves it's not afraid to split the crowd. You'll now only get the allowance if you receive certain benefits, which has irked some party members and the unions. One MP, Rosie Duffield, has reportedly quit over the affair, while the volume of claims for pension credit has rocketed. The union's victory in a non-binding vote to reverse the decision to scrap this allowance was one of the few talking points in an otherwise tame Labour Party conference in late September. This was overshadowed by Starmer's now infamous sausage gaffe and accusations about MPs failing to disclose freebies. However, any clues about which taxes may rise at the budget were strikingly absent. In her conference speech, Reeves said her optimism for Britain burns brighter than ever, but it seems we'll spend some time in the dark before sunnier days arrive.